An Omaha man chases his stolen pickup truck through Council Bluffs into Omaha, all while on the phone with 911. The woman behind the wheel then crashes it and runs from officers. 30-year-old Jessica Katz is jailed tonight. And KTV News Watch 7's Hannah Pickett joins us live from 23rd and K with more. Hannah?
Yeah, Melissa, the chase ended here near 23rd and K when Jessica Katz hit a parked car here on the street. You can still see remnants of that behind. That's before she crashed into a fence that's since been removed by MUD. Now, this whole chase started when the truck's owner spotted it in Council Bluffs.
Officers arrest 30-year-old Jessica Katz Thursday afternoon on several charges, including stealing this crashed red pickup. This after she led officers, deputies, troopers, even the truck's owner on a high-speed chase across state lines.
Felt like an episode of Cops following my stolen vehicle.
The owner, who asks we hide his face, says someone stole the truck from his West Omaha driveway Sunday night and changed its appearance.
The wrong plates on it, stickers removed.
But it didn't work.
The owner says a friend of his spotted the stolen truck near 22nd and N. That's when the owner decided to chase that stolen truck through Council Bluffs near Iowa School for the Deaf, the Lake Manawa area, and then over the South Omaha Bridge, all while on the phone with 911.
And she started getting a little aggressive. I would never recommend chasing a stolen vehicle like I did.
The chase ended here near 23rd and K when Katz crashed into this fence and ran from officers. They caught her a block away.
She said somebody else was in the truck and he had a gun and took off on foot.
Officers put a nearby school on lockdown and secured the neighborhood, only to find Katz lied to them. There was never a gunman. The owner is just glad to have his truck back.
Feels pretty good to see this finally come to an end. I can sleep well at night now with my doors locked.
Now, Katz is jailed tonight in Douglas County on theft and drug charges. Her bond is $4,500. She also has outstanding warrants in both Douglas County and Pottawatomie County. I am told she will likely face flight to avoid arrest in Iowa as well. Reporting live, Hannah Pickett, KETV, NewsWatch 7.